Vaishali, I must compliment you for a great attempt to handle such a case. You know, invariably, when you have a subretinal fragment, there are various ways to look at it. One is that how big is the fragment? Second is where it is located. Because there are reports where the lens fragments have gone to the dialysis and the lens was, you know, the retina was settled and the lens absorbed. Because here your attempt to take it out through that hole, through the retinotomy itself, must have damaged a lot of retina.
Right.
So you have to find out whether if it was in a small segment or a small piece and lying somewhere in the periphery, this lens matter will get absorbed, because the report which is in the literature, if I can share with you, is that they had the piece going through the dialysis. They just settled the retina and over a period of time that settled. Because you did try to do something, and you should have known this when it went in. When you finished your surgery, it was a little bit late, because that is the time when it is going inside, or you have a retinal break or whatever, that is the time you should start, you know, putting after a vitrectomy, start keeping the posterior retina flat and trying to milk it out. And second thing is the amount of cutter you used inside itself, you know, because it is a mostly traumatic subretinal nucleus fragment go there because of, you know, attempt to remove the lens nucleus, which is fallen behind. So as an anterior segment surgeon, I would suggest that do not try to let the posterior segment surgeon do it.
Thanks,
but it's a great job. Rishali. Thank you so much, Rishali. You're doing a great, great surgery.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Dr. Maniar, for this appointment.